logical, not, and, or, conditional, biconditional. These operators are more or less based in how our language works. But some of you maybe had some objections to a few of the truth tables, especially when it comes to logical or. Let's look at the truth table and let's say that A means I will give you a hamburger and B means I will give you fries. Here in the first scenario, both of them are true. And in this case, the disjunction of them is true. If I said to you that I will give a hamburger or fries and then gave you both, did I lie to you? Some might say yes, but in standard logic, we have an inclusive disjunction rule for really good reasons that I will discuss in a future episode. But there is a logical sign for an exclusive disjunction. In this case, the truth table looks like this instead. And this is also sometimes referred to as XOR for exclusive disjunction. But this logical sign is redundant. In other words, it is not needed, for we can express its meaning with the operators we already have discussed. A or B, and it is not the case that A and B. So here we're saying, for an example, that you will get a hamburger or fries, and that is not the case that you will get a hamburger and fries. Thus, we have an exclusive disjunction. This formulation is logically equivalent as the exclusive disjunction operator. In other words, they are interchangeable, or means the same thing. And to show why this is the case, we simply need to look at their respective truth tables. As you can see, the truth tables are identical with each other. Hence, they are logically equivalent. And to express this is through the symbol of logical equivalence. This symbol is different from biconditional, since logical equivalence is not a logical operator. That was why I didn't like calling material biconditional for equivalence. So we don't really need the exclusive disjunction. And there are actually more operators that are redundant in the same manner, and we can show this by looking at the truth tables. If we start with the biconditional, as the logical symbol sort of shows us, it is simply a double material conditional, an arrow that goes both ways. So a biconditional can be expressed as such: if P, then Q, and if Q, then P. And to show this, we simply need to look at the respective truth tables. As you can see, they are true and false in exactly the same places. Hence, they are logically equivalent. And in matters of fact, logical material conditional is itself also redundant. Take the statement, if there is sugar in the cookie, then the cookie is sweet. This statement is logically equivalent to, there is no sugar in the cookie, or the cookie is sweet. Why? Well, same thing here, if we look at the truth table, they are true and false in exactly the same scenarios. Hence, every logical implication can be expressed through a disjunction and a negation. Therefore, every biconditional can also be expressed through a disjunction and a negation, right? So we don't really need any of these. In other words, all logical operators can be expressed by only using these three operators: logical and or and negation. And the funny thing is, it can actually be reduced even further. But then we need two completely new operators. One called NAND, not AND, and NOR, neither nor. Here is the truth table for those operators. And here is the thing. All logical operators can be expressed through these two, which means that we can create a fully complete logical system with only two operators. So logic can indeed be reduced to binary functions. And what else is binary? Well, ones and zeros. well, binary code. I'm not a coding expert, but this is certainly related. But just because we can reduce everything to binary code doesn't mean that we have to. It can become incredibly complex with only two operators. It is way simpler to use all the standard operators, for they are more grounded in common language. If you enjoyed this episode, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and take care until the next one.